Well, Scotty, what do you think of our campsite? Here it is. It's pretty nice here. Got a lot of woods behind us. Nobody right here. That's the only bad thing with these angled ones is the back of the person's trailer is right kind of in your sight a little bit. But not bad. See our trailer. The winds, we've been pretty protected from the wind down here, so we've been able to keep our awning out. And here's our little screened in place. We can sit evening. Really not too bad. But everybody's been pretty good and keeping their social distancing. It's been nice, so we've been able to cook out a little bit.
Said it was going to be overcast all afternoon. It's still in the 70s. And the wind is supposed to be like 4 to 6 miles an hour with gusts 5 to 8 or something. So not too bad. I've got mosquitoes and spiders and everything in here around me. It's overcast, so you can take it off if you want to. It's kind of pretty up in there, but. Not Alaska. Not Canada. The one we really, I think, would have been great to have a ton of islands and fingers in it, Boy Lake. Yeah. It's been quite a storm to blew that all the way down up in here.
At it.
We thought we'd just, since we're quarantined here, we'd do a little, some cooking shows. But anyways, a lot of our meals, we try to achieve a couple things. One is use very little pots or pans, so we have less to clean, especially when we're boondocking, and ingredients and things that you can buy. Now, that being said, some of it's not real fresh and stuff, and it's packaged stuff, but sometimes when you're moving, you need something you can make a meal real quick, no mess, and be done. And this is one of our favorites, an Italian meal. So We'll start right here. First thing is, I'm going to use one skillet, and this is one of my favorite skillets. It's a Lodge steel skillet. We started carrying these instead of the cast iron skillets. They're a lot less weight, and they work real good. This one's a 10-inch one. And if you look them up on Lodge, they're really good. They have a nice long handle, too, that barely gets hot. And they're great out on this thing. So what we're going to cook is we're going to have a pasta with marinara sauce and some Italian sausage. We found these. They're ready pastas. They're fully cooked by Barilla, or Barilla, not sure. And there's the two we usually get are called Rotini or Gemelli. And I know it's kind of cheating. It's not the best pasta. You know, it's not like being in a nice Italian restaurant. But it serves a purpose in that we don't have to get another pot out, boil all this water, and cook the pasta. So what I usually do first is, I'm going to use some Italian sausage. I'm going to cut it up like this and start cooking it. So I've cut up our sausage in the little pieces, maybe about a half inch thick, okay? And I'm going to take my pan and I'm going to use a little olive oil. Yeah, maybe about that much. I'm going to throw a few spices in it. I always like a little extra spice, so I'm using just a little Italian seasoning. And I think I'll just throw a little garlic salt in there. And then we'll fire this up. Let's see if that's enough. There we go. Get some heat going. I'm gonna stir this around a little bit. See how it coats the pan. There, get that all in there. So now I'm gonna go ahead and just heat these up and cook them and brown them. And you want them just about fully cooked. Well, using the sausage, I'd fully cook it. Oh, this smells so good. Sometimes when I'm cooking, I like to use one of these. You know, it's just a dome. I've got this one at Academy. Because you can just stick it over. It does a couple things, especially if you're cooking in the camper. Cooking this on the stove, and we cook it inside a lot. It keeps the grease from splattering, but it also will trap some heat, and the stuff will cook through a little faster sometimes. So I use this a lot when I'm cooking different meals. Especially if it's like rice or something in here, it'll help hold the moisture in. Cook a little longer. So we got the sausage browned and it's pretty cooked. So now what I'm going to do, you can see, stir it up a little bit. Got a little brown on it. It's good. There's enough, I think, enough oil. You could add a little bit of olive oil right now if you needed to. But we're going to have the Gemelli. It says ready in 60 seconds. So just dump that right in there. Kind of mix it up, get it down there in the bottom. Like I said, at this point, you could add a little more olive oil. And if you didn't want sauce, this is a great time. Just cook it through, throw in some vegetables with it if you wanted to. A little roasted red peppers maybe, and just eat it that way. We're going to use a marinara sauce. So now I'm going to put that in, and I'm going to put just a touch of olive oil on it. Just a little. Not that much. And I'm going to throw me a little more Italian seasoning in here. And a touch more of garlic salt. Precisely measured, as you can see. Kind of stir that up, get that oil up in there working around. I then I'm going to let this sit for just maybe a minute. Keep heating. I've got it on a low heat now. Okay, so I've let this cook just about a minute is all. Get that oil, get everything coated, get all those nice things. And then all I do now is I just take some, unfortunately, canned sauce. But, you know, again, we're trying to be simple here. And you just got to kind of add it to your liking. Let's try that right there. And then just give it a good stir. Put that top on there and let that sit for a couple minutes. And then we'll give it a check, stir it probably a couple more times and be good. Then that kind of sit there and marinate a little. You can leave it on low for a while and it won't hurt anything at this point. Make sure it doesn't dry out and there's enough thing. You can see some of the oils coming out and the sauce. You just want to get that sauce nice and warmed up. I'm going to give it just another minute or two. Okay, so now we've heated the sauce all the way through, mixed it up. You got it like that, and it's now ready to serve. Then, right now I'm just going to top it with a little Parmesan. And there you have it. A little Italian meal, one pot dirty, and took probably less than 15 minutes.